I'm Tamara.
And I'm Adam.
And
are we looking at the camera?
And we are El Gastrónomo Vagabundo. We're the first gourmet food truck in Ontario, and we do a lot of globally inspired flavors. We try to use as much local produce as possible, but a lot of our flavors are Southeast Asian. There's an Australian spin on things with Adam's background, and we play around with some different Middle Eastern and Mediterranean flavors as well.
So some examples of the food we do are gourmet tacos, a lot of Calimax style, so fish tacos with fresh flavors, Southeast Asian inspired street food dishes, and built salads or composed salads, so things that utilize local ingredients through the seasons, and we build and compose the salads to have beautiful fresh flavors and colors on the plate. So the name for the truck was thought up by Tam. It's a kickback to food trucks down in California. A lot of them are Mexican or were taco trucks. So essentially we're just giving an ode to the taco trucks of the past with the name. So El Gastrónomo Vagabundo, it's a Spanish name. That's the ode, giving a bit of Spanish thought, but we're far from Spanish. The tacos that we do are not Mexican, they're not Spanish inspired, so it's just an ode to them, but it basically loosely translates, or does translate, to the roaming vagabond, or the gourmet vagabond. The reason why we opened a truck as opposed to a brick and mortar restaurant is purely because of money factors. We didn't have enough money to start a restaurant, so we looked at our options and we came up with the idea to open a food truck. So wasn't being done at the time, was in the States, it was really taking off down there, so we thought we'll give it a crack up here and bit the bullet and did it.
And since we started just over 2 years ago, like a year ago from now, we were one of the only trucks, and now there's an industry growing, and we're preparing for the first annual Awestruck Food Truck Awards, which is pretty exciting. There are, I think, 14 eligible trucks, and hopefully it just keeps growing and expanding and we see more diversity with street food.
So now we're going to head inside and I'm going to show you how to make our taco. I'm just going to show you how to do our cod taco or fish taco that we do, starting off with getting some fish fried. So lightly flour it and then place it into a batter. The batter we make is soda water and self-raising flour. You want it fairly thin, but not too thin. And that goes into the fryer. While our fish cooks, we cook all our tortillas to order so they're nice and fresh. So just a light bit of oil on a flat top or in your pan at home. Throw your tortillas on. Tortillas come off and just go in our tortilla holding vessel. So when the fish is done, it should be nice and golden brown and crispy. Bowl with some paper towel so it soaks up any excess oil, and then we plate. So place your tortillas on a plate or in a container, place your fish in, and then comes the garnish. So some of our slaw, which is green apple and red cabbage with tarragon dressing. So beautiful colour, nice and fresh, nice and crisp. Our sauces. So one's a toasted coconut sour cream and our own hot smoked pineapple and habanero hot sauce. So a bit of that. Finishing touches with a bit of coriander. And tacos wouldn't be out tacos without a nice fresh wedge of lime. So they are our fresh, beautiful cod tacos.
Today we are in Niagara on the Lake. We're at the Supper Market, which is held by the Farmers Market at the Village. It's a weekly event where there's different food vendors. There's fresh shucked oysters, smoked ribs, there's wood-fired pizza, and tonight's actually the first night that they're also pouring wine, which is pretty exciting. It's a great little market. Everyone here is just here for food and community, and it's really what food should be about.